Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. O come, O let the whole earth stand in awe of him. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways, Elohim. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done, and apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess their faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun, and our eyes be all of us blind. We sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. Praise the Lord, O my soul, O Lord my God. You have become exceedingly glorious. You are clothed with majesty and honor. You clothe yourself with light as with a garment, and spread out the heavens like a curtain. You lay the beams of your chambers in the waters, and make the clouds your chariot, and walk upon the wings of the wind. You make winds your messengers, and flames of fire your ministers. You laid the foundations of the earth, that it never should move at any time. You cover it with the deep, as with a garment. The waters stand above the hills. At your rebuke they fled. At the voice of your thunder they hastened away. They went up as high as the hills and down to the valleys beneath, even to the place you had appointed for them. You have set bounds for them which they shall not pass, neither shall they again cover the earth. You send the springs into the rivers which run over the hills. All beasts of the field drink thereof, and the wild donkeys quench their thirst. Besides them shall the birds of the air have their habitation and sing among the branches. You water the hills from above. The earth is filled with the fruit of your works. You bring forth grass for the cattle, and plants for the service of mankind, that they may bring food out of the earth, and wine that makes glad the heart, and oil to make a cheerful countenance, and bread to strengthen the heart. The trees of the Lord also are full of sap, even the cedars of Lebanon, which he planted, wherein the birds make their nests, and in the fir trees are a dwelling for the stork. The high hills are a refuge for the wild goats, so are the stony cliffs for the rock badgers. You appointed the moon to mark the seasons, and the sun knows it's going down. You make darkness that it may be night in which all the beasts of the forest move. The lions roaring after their prey seek their meat from God. The sun arises and they go away together and lay themselves down in their tents. Man goes forth to his work and to his labor until the evening. O Lord, how manifold are your works. In wisdom you made them all. The earth is full of your creatures. So is the great and wild sea also, in which are things creeping innumerable, creatures both small and great. There goes the ships, and there's that Leviathan whom you made to take its pleasure therein. These all wait upon you, that you may give them food in due season. When you give it to them, they gather it, and when you open your hand, they are filled with good things. When you hide your face, they are troubled. When you take away their breath, they die, and are turned again to their dust. When you let your breath go forth, they shall be made, and you shall renew the face of the earth. The glorious majesty of the Lord shall endure forever. The Lord shall rejoice in his works. He looks at the earth and it trembles. If he even touches the hills, they shall smoke. I will sing unto the Lord as long as I live. I will praise my God while I have my being. And so shall my words please him. My joy shall be in the Lord. As for sinners, they shall perish from the earth, and the ungodly shall come to an end. Praise the Lord, O my soul. Praise the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Ezra, beginning with the 8th chapter, the 1st verse. Now these are the heads of their fathers' households, and the genealogical enrollment of those who went up with me from Babylon in the reign of King Artaxerxes, of the sons of Phinehas, Gershom, and the sons of Ithamar, Daniel, of the sons of David, Hattush, and the son of Shechaniah, who was of the sons of Parosh, Zechariah, and with him 150 males who were in the genealogical lists. Of the sons of Pahathbod, Elihoinai, the son of Zerahiah, and 200 males with him. Of the sons of Zatu, Shekinai, the son of Hazaziel, and 300 males with him. And of the sons of Adin, Abed, and the son of Jonathan, and 50 males with him. And of the sons of Elam, Jeshaiah, the son of Ataliah, and 70 males with him. And of the sons of Jepatiah, the son of Michael, and 80 males with him. Of the sons of Job, Obadiah, the son of Jehiel, and 218 males with him. And of the sons of Bani, Shalomith, the son of Josephiah, and 160 males with him. And of the sons of Bidai, Zechariah, and the son of Badai, and 28 males with him. And of the sons of Azgad, Johanan, the son of Hakatan, and 110 males with him. And of the sons of Adonai, Kam, the last ones, these being their names, either Philet, Jelil, and Shemaiah, and 60 males with them. And of the sons of Bigvai, Uthai and Saput and 17 males with them. Now I assembled them at the river that runs to Ahava, where we camped for 3 days, and when I paid close attention to the people and the priests, I did not find any Levites there. So I sent for Eliezer, Ariel, Shema'iah, Ilnitan, Jarib, Ilnitan, Nathan, Zechariah, and Meshulam, leading men for the Jarib, and Ilnitan, teachers. And I sent them to Edo, the leading man, in the place called Kasifaya. And I told them what to say to Edo and his brothers, the temple servants, at the place Kasifaya. That is to bring ministers to us for the house of our God. And as the good hand of our God was upon us, they brought us a man of insight from the sons of Mahali, the son of Levi, the son of Israel, namely Sherebiah and his sons and brothers, 18 men, and Heshabiah and Jeshaiah of the sons of Merari and his sons and their sons, 20 men, and 220 of the temple servants, whom David and the officials had provided for the service of the Levites, all of them designated by name. Then I proclaimed a fast there at the river of Ahava to humble ourselves before our God, to seek from him a safe journey for us, our little ones, and all our possessions. For I was ashamed to request from the king troops and horsemen to protect us from the enemy on the way, because we have said to the king, the hand of our God is favorably disposed to all who seek him, but his power and his anger are against all those who abandon him. So we fasted and sought our God concerning this matter, and he listened to our preaching, our pleading. Then I selected 12 of the leading priests, Sherebiah, Hashabiah, and with them 10 of their brothers, and I weighed out to them the silver, the gold, and the utensils, the offering for the house of our God, which the king, his counselors, his officials, and all Israel who were present there had contributed. So I weighed into their hands 650 talents of silver and silver utensils worth 100 talents and 100 gold talents and 20 gold bowls worth 1,000 darics and 2 utensils of fine shiny bronze precious as gold. Then I said to them, you are holy to the Lord, and the utensils are holy, and the silver and the gold are a voluntary offering to the Lord God of your fathers. Watch and keep them until you weigh them before the leading priests, the Levites, and the leaders of the fathers' households in Israel and Jerusalem, in the chambers of the house of the Lord. So the priests and the Levites accepted the weight of silver and gold and the utensils to bring them to Jerusalem, to the house of our God. Then we journeyed from the river Ahava on the 12th of the first month to go to Jerusalem, and the hand of our God was upon us, and he rescued us from the hand of the enemy and the ambushes by the road. So we came to Jerusalem and remained there for 3 days. And on the fourth day, the silver, the gold, and the utensils were weighed out in the house of our God into the hand of Merimoth, the son of Uriah the priest, and with him was Eleazar, the son of Phinehas, and with them were the Levites, Jozabad, the son of Jeshua, and Noadiah, the son of Binui. A notation was made for everything by number and weight, and all the weight was recorded at that time. The exiles who had come from the captivity offered burnt offerings to the God of Israel, 12 bulls for all Israel, 96 rams, 77 lambs, 12 male goats for a sin offering, all as a burnt offering to the Lord. Then they delivered the king's edicts to the king's satraps and the governors in the provinces beyond the Euphrates River, and they supported the people and the house of God. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of God, and the glory of the Lord has dawned upon you. For behold, darkness covers the land, deep gloom enshrouds the peoples. But over you the Lord will rise, and his glory will appear upon you. Nations will stream to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawning. Your gates will always be open, by day or night they will never be shut. They will call you the city of the Lord, the Zion of the Holy One of Israel. Violence will no more be heard in your land, ruin or destruction within your borders. You will call your walls salvation, all your portals praise. The sun will no more be your light by day. By night, you will not need the brightness of the moon. The Lord will be your everlasting light, and your God will be your glory. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from St. Paul's second epistle to St. Timothy, beginning with the third chapter, the first verse. But realize this, that in the last days, difficult times will come, for people will be lovers of self, lovers of money, boastful, arrogant, slanderous, disobedient to parents, ungrateful, unholy, unloving, irreconcilable, malicious gossips, without self-control, brutal, haters of good, treacherous, reckless, conceited, lovers of pleasure, rather than lovers of God, holding to a form of godliness, although they have denied its power. Avoid such people as these, for among them are those who slip into households and captivate weak women weighed down with sins, led on by various impulses, always learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. Just as Jannes and Jambres opposed Moses, so these men also oppose the truth, men of depraved mind, worthless in regard to the faith. But they will not make further progress, for their foolishness will be obvious to all, just as was that also of Jannes and Jambres. Now you followed my teaching, conduct, purpose, faith, patience, love, perseverance, persecutions and sufferings, such as happened to me at Antioch, at Iconium, at Lystra, what persecutions I endure, and out of them all the Lord rescued me. Indeed, all who want to live in a godly way in Christ Jesus will be persecuted, but evil people and impostors will proceed from bad to worse, deceiving and being deceived. You, however, continue in the things you have learned and become convinced of, knowing from whom you have learned them, and that from childhood you have known the sacred writings, which are able to give you the wisdom that leads to salvation through faith, which is in Christ Jesus. All scripture is inspired by God and beneficial for teaching, for rebuke, for correction, for training in righteousness, so that the man or woman of God may be fully capable, equipped for every good work. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. For he has regarded the loneliness of his handmaiden. But behold, from now on, all generations will call me blessed. For he that is mighty has magnified me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is on those who fear. Throughout all generations, he has shown the strength of his arm. He scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones, and has exalted the humble and meek. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. He, remembering his mercy, has helped his servant Israel, as he promised to our fathers Abraham and his seed forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, a world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended to the dead. The third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Lord, be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful, we entreat you, Lord. That your holy angels may lead us in paths of peace and goodwill, we entreat you, Lord. That we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses, we entreat you, Lord. That there may be peace in your church and in the whole world, we entreat you, Lord. That we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ, we entreat you, O Lord. Let your merciful ears, O Lord, be open to the prayers of your humble servants, and that we may receive what we ask. Teach us by your Holy Spirit to ask only those things that are pleasing to you, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with you in the same Spirit lives and reigns, forever and ever. Amen. Lord Jesus, stay with us. For evening is at hand, and the day is past. Be our companion in the way, kindle our hearts, and awaken hope, that we may know you as you are revealed in Scripture and the breaking of bread. Grant this for the sake of your love. Amen. O God and Father of all, whom the whole heavens adore, let the whole earth also worship you, all nations obey you, all tongues confess and bless you, and men, women, and children everywhere love you and serve you in peace, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all your days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this one knowledge of your truth and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit.